Yep, you know what this theme tune means. Time for a bit of Daily Chelsea. Obviously, Rory Jennings with us, big Chelsea fan. No doubt we're going to get his reaction to what's going on at Chelsea. A couple of incomings as well. Transfer insider, Addy Oladipo, Rory Jennings. First one, Nicholas Jackson. We were talking about this before the show starts, and we're like, is he now your forward? Is he now your number nine? Obviously, you got him from Villarreal. We're in a fee of around 30 million euros. You think not?
No, I don't. I don't think that Nicholas Jackson will be leading the line for Chelsea. I think it's a fairly uninspiring front line if he is. I don't think he will start. I don't think he will be our main man. Sadly, I have a terrible feeling that our main man, as things stand, is Romelu Lukaku. Mm. And I think that Mauricio Pochettino may well have come into Chelsea and said, everybody's going to have a clean slate. Everybody has the same opportunity to impress. Everybody can state their case to be in the first team. And I think that Romelu Lukaku is probably best placed to be Chelsea's starting attacker.
It's a weird signing, this one. I mean, look at his record. And look, obviously, look, sometimes stats and figures don't really tell the true story. You have to go and watch someone. I know he's had his injuries last season. When he came back, he scored a bunch of goals. But 2021-22, this is in La Liga for Villarreal. Nine starts, so 10 appearances, no goals. Mm. None, zero. Last season, in total, 38 appearances, 13 goals. He's signed for Chelsea.
Yes.
You know what I mean? It's not like he's done anything.
But Addy, we've seen enough signings and we're well-versed in this enough to know that lots of signings are made by lots of clubs, particularly the top clubs, when there's no real genuine expectation for them to play for the first team ever.
Yeah, to move on immediately.
Like, it wouldn't surprise me. Chelsea have apparently now linked up with Strasbourg. There's a situation where, as part of Chelsea's multi-club development, Strasbourg are going to be part of that. I wouldn't be surprised to see Nicholas Jackson leading the line for Strasbourg.
Yeah, agreed. Same won't happen with Nkunku, would it?
He looks more ready
to be thrown straight into it and be one of your main forward targets. Your big target this summer looks to be Moises Caicedo, obviously heavily linked with Arsenal. That didn't work out in the January transfer window. We know Brighton want a lot of money. When I say a lot, people, I mean Brighton want over £100 million for him. Mm. Still going to be your man, you think?
I think he has to be, but it's, I don't think it will be for that money, though.
Yeah.
I mean, Chelsea do spend a lot of money, though. We do get ripped off. You know, if you think we spent well over £100 million on Enzo Fernandez... Mm. Don't get me wrong, I know he's coming off the back of the World Cup, but he didn't exactly have pedigree.
Yeah.
You know, he went into that World Cup as a player that wasn't even necessarily supposed to be starting for Argentina. I think at one point, actually, he was very lucky to even make the squad.
Yeah.
Of course, he shone when he was there and played very well and contributed to them winning the World Cup. But ultimately, he didn't have much pedigree when we signed him.
I guess you could apply the same logic to Mudryk.
Of course you can.
Yeah, same.
And Caicedo actually probably has the most because he has a season under his belt, Premier League proven. And I think Chelsea now desperately need him. If you think about where Chelsea are weak, it's all very well. I think if I were to say that Chelsea are weak at right back, I think you would probably counter that. You start talking to me about the brilliance of Reece James. You start telling me how good Reece James is and how he's arguably one of the best right backs in the world and how he's certainly the best right back in the league. You would be correct, but there's a major issue with Reece James. He's never fit. His injury record is so frustrating. And when you have Reece James in your squad, effectively what you have to do is proceed as if you don't. Mm. And if he's available, fantastic. If he is available, if Reece James is available and on form, there's nobody better. But you really do need to be aware that Reece James probably won't be available. With Cesar Azpilicueta moving on...
We'll talk about him in a minute, yeah.
With Cesar Azpilicueta moving on, it effectively means that Chelsea are down a right back. We have a very good right back who has major injury problems. Remember, Todd Boehly sacked our entire medical team as well, so there's another issue there. And very recently, we've just discussed Mason Mount leaving, which leaves us light in the middle. Mateo Kovacic has gone to Manchester City, and N'Golo Kante has gone to Saudi. We need both a midfielder, and we need to totally reinvent our midfield, but we also need cover at right back. Moises Caicedo is effectively two in one, isn't he? Mm. He's a very good right back, particularly in this new world in which we play inverted right backs. He can do a great job there. So when Reece James is fit, fantastic. Moises Caicedo plays central midfield. But when Reece James isn't available, which is fairly regularly,
yeah,
Caicedo can slot in there.
It's going to be very interesting to see if Arsenal don't actually say to Declan Rice, we need a decision now. Because Arsenal were very interested in Caicedo. Obviously, the number one choice is Declan Rice. But if Declan Rice is going to Man City, they don't want to miss out on Caicedo as well. So you almost feel like they're going to actually put, you know, a little memo to West Ham saying, look, can you tell us, please, what's he going to do? Is he coming us or is he going to Man City?
Well, this is why Arsenal do actually have a lot of bargaining power.
Very.
If Arsenal were to effectively, it doesn't have to be true, but, you know, ostensibly pull out of the race for Declan Rice and focus on Caicedo, that would suddenly lead to impetus in this move from West Ham, I'm sure. But I think Caicedo's a great player. I think he's everything that Chelsea need.
Good
Premier
player,
League proven is so important.
Yeah, 100 million quid is ridiculous.
It is ridiculous.
How much did they get him for again?
I mean,
it was scary, wasn't it?
You can't really think about that, particularly with regard to Brighton. Brighton are arguably the best run club in the world. Tony Bloom is a magician with the way that he does things. And I think when you think about what they have managed to do time and time again, whoever replaces Caicedo, I'm sure that it'll be fantastic. Mm. You know, like last year, they lost Cucurella. Cucurella was their player of the year, Brighton's player of the year, and they lost him. Manchester City were flirting with Cucurella. It didn't work out. Suddenly he's gone to Chelsea. They're never going to cope. They bring in Estupiñán, who's even better. Yeah. They lose their manager. They bring in a manager who's even better. They lose Basuma. They're never going to be able to cope. Suddenly Caicedo's there. They are so perfect in this game of recruitment that I'm sure that they are going to be fine.
All right, let's talk about, you mentioned there, Cesar Azpilicueta. I know you've wanted him out of the club for a long time, not because you don't like him, just because in terms of the job that needs to be done on that right side, he can no longer do it. Looks like Inter Milan are the favourites for his signature, a two-year deal reportedly agreed.
I think this is so necessary. Mm. You know, I think Cesar Azpilicueta hasn't been good enough to play for Chelsea for about 3 years. Mm. Like, he really hasn't. He hasn't played well. He can only play a very particular system. He's so profligate on the ball. Like, on the ball has never been where he excels. Like, in terms of being a rugged, robust, aggressive, dogged defender, in terms of stopping you...
He certainly ticks that box.
Yeah, well, I mean, you've got to remember, when he first arrived at Chelsea, I think we signed him from Marseille, he started playing left-back. He kept Ashley Cole out of the team. You know, he was the moment where I think Ashley Cole...
That's how long he's been at Chelsea.
We signed a right back from Marseille for about 7 million quid. When he first arrived, he kicked Ashley Cole out of the team at left back. Cesar Azpilicueta was one of those right-footed left backs initially. Mm. He's then been brilliant for Chelsea. The year that we won the league, he played in what I believe is actually his best position, certainly his most fruitful season for Chelsea. He played on the right side of a back three. David Luiz, Gary Cahill and Cesar Azpilicueta. As a back three, they were brilliant because David Luiz played a really unique role and he played it just beautifully. He's such a good footballer, David Luiz. You know, he had his flaws, but he played it so well. What he would do is effectively defend like John Terry would, but also create our attacks in the midfield. He'd step up, leave Azpilicueta and Gary Cahill behind. He'd step up and start our attacks the way Fabregas would. And that year, Cesar Azpilicueta was phenomenal. He's been a great player for Chelsea. He will go down as one of our best. He isn't our best ever right back, but he's one of our best. But he needs to leave. Mm. And I'm grateful for everything that he's done, but it's long overdue that he is no longer a Chelsea player.
And final one, not saying this to annoy you, AC Milan is said to have made an offer for your good mate Romelu Lukaku.
Yeah, I mean, that is good news.
That will surprise me if he goes AC Milan. I mean, look, we see it actually quite a lot. There's a lot of players that have played for both Inter and AC, but it would surprise me.
It would surprise you on what level? Because you believe that Romelu Lukaku is a principled man who wouldn't betray his Inter following by going to sign...
Yeah, to Inter, yeah.
You honestly think
that?
Yeah,
I do.
I can guarantee you that that won't factor in Romelu Lukaku's decision-making process at all. Romelu Lukaku is a narcissist who is only interested in self-gratification. He has no loyalty or love to anyone other than himself. And if AC Milan are ready to pay him the money and put him in the first team, he will not think about Inter Milan ever again.
All right.
On AM, on DAB, via the TalkSport app and on your smart speaker. TalkSport.